Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise bring about addition. And these people we are praising for the disciple, God, we are bringing addition to them. We are going to be praying today and say, Lord, give me the grace to praise you. Grace bring increase. I ask for grace or praise to just be praising you for who you are. Lord, give me the grace. I need the addition, oh God. Give me grace to just praise you. As the brothers of the whole did, and you have it to the touch daily. Lord, grace to be praising you for who you are. Lord, give us the grace as a church to just be praising you.
Sufficient.
Praise and bring about addition, Lord. Increase. Lifting. We ask for grace today, Lord.
That brings increase.
To praise you, O Lord. To praise you for who you are as the Lord Almighty. As the root and the offspring of David, the bright and the morning star. Father, give us grace this morning. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we see grace.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Our second prayer will be taken from the book of Isaiah chapter 6, verse 8. Isaiah chapter 6, verse 8 is saying, God was asking a question. Who shall I send? Who will go for us? My people have been wandering in destruction. Who shall I send now that we go and rescue them? And the young man said, Isaiah said, Lord, here I am, send me. We are going to be praying today and say, Lord, I am here, O God, for you to use me for your glory. I am here, Lord, to surrender myself to you, Lord. Send me, Lord, for I am ready to be your messenger. Send me, O Lord. Send me, O Lord, to deliver the world, to help people. To share the good tidings to people, Lord. To save those, oh God, that are wandering in destruction. Father, save me. I am available, Lord. Take on my available. You are available. Lord, I am available. Save me, Lord, in this great assignment. To stand to intercede and be interceding for your people. Isaiah said, Lord, here I am, send me. Father, we are here today, Lord. Send us. We are willing to go for you. You are you alone. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
The Lord will send us for now, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We are still going to pray today. We want to be praying from the book of Philippians chapter 3, verse 10. Philippians chapter 3, verse 10, Apostle Paul was saying here, that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. All the days and the years of Apostle Paul serving the Lord, he still had the mind to say that I may know him upon all the things he did for the Lord.
Yes.
Today we are going to pray, Lord, open my heart to the power of the resurrection of Jesus. I want to know you, Lord, more than the way I know you now. Ask God for this. Tell him, people, tell you, want to know him. He should expose you to his power of the resurrection. Lord, expose us, Lord, to the power of your resurrection. We want to know you, O Lord, better than this. We want to know you better than this. Just the way you are, Lord. We want to be a partaker, Lord, of the power that led Jesus to be there. That I may know him and the power of the resurrection. Lord, draw us closer to yourself, Lord, to begin to know you, to know your power, to experience and begin to walk in line with the power that led Jesus with them. Father, Lord, we are here, Lord, exposed unto your power of resurrection. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
The Lord will introduce himself to us one and all in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We are going to be praying this from the book of Proverbs chapter 18 verse 16. It said, a man's gifts make a way for him and make him to sit among great men. I know every one of us here want to see the kings and queens, noble people in the society. This is the time for us to pray. God has deposited something inside of us, which is the gift. We are going to say, Lord, help me discover the gift that will make me to sit among kings, among the queens, among the nobles. In the name of Jesus, we need to pray. Father, Lord, the gift among the gift you have deposited in me, the potential, the one that will make me to sit among the kings. God, help me to do it. Lord, help me to discover it in the name of Jesus. Lord, you have given us a gift. You have given us a gift that will make us a standard over the nations of the earth, Lord. Father, help us to discover it. Help us to know it, Lord. Give us the ability, Lord, to walk with it, to know it. In the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name, we can pray. Our gift will make a way for you.
Amen.
Beginning from today, every gift God has put inside you will make a way and it will introduce you to kings and queens in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Lastly, we are going to pray this from the book of 1 Corinthians 10, verse 12. 1 Corinthians 10, verse 12. It said, let me that ticket is done, take him, lest he fall.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Me and you, we are here today not because we are too special, it's just because of the grace of God that is keeping us. Me and you, we are standing declaring God's word, it's because of his grace. Not that we are better than that man, that woman that is not there. We are going to be saying, Lord, give me grace to keep standing in you. I don't want to fall, I refuse to fall. Grace of God to keep standing and raising those that are falling, Lord. Release not to me today. Begin to pray to God this hour. Ask God for his grace. Ask God for his grace for you to keep standing. As you are standing, to be raising those that are falling. Many are falling out of faith. Many are backsliding. Many are out there doing what they are not supposed to do. Condition put them into it. And you are here standing. We are let us intercede for those people. Let's ask God for grace for their life to stand. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. You will never go down, you will never fall.
Amen.
You will be the one that will be raising others that are falling.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.